Let's take a quick tour of the course. Notice that this video was created when the course was still being put together, so there may be some subtle differences by the time you take the course. When you enter the course, you will want to look at the latest announcements, which are listed in this region. If you want to review previous announcements, you will want to click on Updates here to the right. This is particularly important if you joined the course late. Below that, on the right, is a listing of important dates. It is important to familiarize yourself with the various tabs. The first tab, labeled Course, takes you back to this page. The next tab, labeled Discussion, takes you to the discussion forum, which is the primary way in which you will interact with us and with other learners. Next comes the Notes tab. Clicking on it will take you to a page that gives you different choices for accessing the notes. We recommend that you use the online book, accessed by clicking on the Access the Online Book link. It was created with an authoring system called Pretext and includes all videos, homework, and answers to the homework. Some prefer reading a PDF with all materials in one place. You may, for example, want to mark this up with your own notes. However, realize that the PDF will initially change frequently as we track down typos and add new material in response to questions. So, your marked up copy may be out of date soon. Finally, we will make all materials conveniently downloadable from our webpage, ulaff.net. This may not happen for a while. By clicking the Progress tab, you can track your progress in the course. There you will find a bar graph and a summary of all sections and what questions have been answered or not answered. The Syllabus tab will take you to the syllabus for the course. The Wiki tab takes you to the Wiki. Since we have not yet decided if we will use the Wiki, there is no content there yet. You will not see the Instructor tab, since that tab is for course staff. Now, let's get back to the course page. A little down that page, you find an outline for the course. We have divided the course into 5 weeks. Week 0 tells you how to set up for the course. Weeks 1 through 4 is where the learning happens. Looking at week 1 as an example, we see that it has been partitioned into sections. Each section is partitioned into units. A typical week starts with a launch. This is an activity that gives you a peek at what you will learn that week. Next, we give an outline for the week, followed by a discussion of what you will learn in the week. When you finish a week, you may want to come back to this unit, since this provides you with a checklist of what it is that you should have learned. If we now look at a typical unit in a later section, we find that it contains a number of components. There are typically one or more videos. There is a place to discuss the content of the unit on the discussion forum. There is a reading assignment. Click on Link takes you directly to the unit in the notes. Finally, there are typically some exercises. After you answer an exercise, be sure to click Submit. Notice that you can click on Answer even before you answer the problem. We want you to learn efficiently. Sometimes you get hung up on a problem, and having a peek at the solution gets you over the hump. You can also go back and re-answer a problem if you get it wrong. If we now return to the outline, we can point out a few more features of the course. In each week, we include an enrichment section. There we point you to related materials that go beyond the core material of the course. We have had such sections in our other MOOCs, and people often comment that it is in those sections that some of the real diamonds are found. It allows you to get a peek at our frontier. The last section in the week includes a unit with extra exercises and a unit that summarizes the material. As you work through the material, you will notice green check marks next to some units. These indicate that you have completed the unit. Let's return to a unit. As discussed, the reading assignment gives you easy access to the unit in the notes that corresponds to this unit on the edX platform. As you look at the notes, you find out that they also contain the videos, the homework, and the answers. You may want to make the notes your primary resource. You will probably want to watch the videos on edX, since the transcription is more convenient there. Notice that if you click on a sentence in the transcription on the side, it takes you to that part of the video. You will want to do the homework on edX so you can make progress towards the certificate if you opted for a verified certificate. Anyway, poke around a bit and get a feel for how it all works. You'll be comfortable with the setup before you know it. If you have questions, just reach out to us on the discussion forum.